Newton and Ferguson, we are going to see the king. Soon and Ferguson, we are going to see the king. Soon and Ferguson, we are going to see the king. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we are going to see the king. No more diamonds, we are going to see the king. No more diamonds, we are going to see the king. No more diamonds, we are going to see the king. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we are going to see the king. Hallelujah.
Good morning, church. Good morning, family. Good morning, friends near and afar, within New Zealand and any nation of the world that have this opportunity to join us in our service this morning. Whakaalofla hi atu ke ngori rifu hi atu tolo iki ko Jesu Christ. Ki orana, aloflava, and ki ora to all friends and families were sharing with us or were part of this service for Newton PIC Parish. Let us worship God. I love the Lord because he hears me He listens to my prayers. He listens to me every time I call to him. What can I offer the Lord for all his goodness to me? I will bring a wine offering to the Lord to thank him for saving me. In the assembly of all his people, I will give him what I have promised. I will give you a sacrifice of thanksgiving and offer my prayer to you. In the assembly of all your people, in the sanctuary of your temple in Jerusalem, I will give you what I have promised. Praise the Lord. Let us pray. Living God, your name today is God everlasting. We thank you for your truth, which exceeds the understanding of our minds, but changes our lives. We thank you for your Son, Christ Jesus, our Lord, whose love reaches out to us and calls us into a new and a deeper relationship with you. And we thank you for the gift of the Holy Spirit and for all the Spirit brings to those who call upon you in Christ's name. Bless our time together, Lord God, and draw us closer to you and to one another, so that the world may see your glory. And with us, render you praise and honor and thanksgiving now and forevermore. Amen. Our first hymn is one of the hymns that was sung by our English-speaking group in one of the choir festival. It's Moments Like This. Let's stand and sing together, or lie down, or sitting down, wherever, whatever posture you are okay with. Let's sing praises to the Lord.
It's moment.
prayer of confession. Let us pray. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbors near and far, in thought and word and actions. There are so many times when our hearts turn away from you, Lord God, when we become angry or judgmental, when we speak falsehoods, when we wasted your blessings, and when we desire the things that are not ours. Forgive us. Help us speak words of encouragement and love, and help us follow your ways, that we may be your faithful followers. In your holy name we pray. Amen. Words of assurance. In God's faithfulness, we are made well. In Christ's love, we discover righteousness and peace. In the Spirit's sustaining power, we find strength for the journey. You are forgiven. Thanks be to God. Amen. As people of hope and disciples of holy love, let us share signs of joy and peace with one another this day. Peace of Christ be with you. Peace of Christ be with you. Peace of Christ be with you. Now we'll hear the word of God from the Holy Scriptures. It will be read by our clerk, Mrs. Melanie Andrew.
Reading this morning comes from the New Testament, the Acts of the Apostles, Acts chapter 11, verses 27 to 30. The Gospel, the Acts of the Gospel, chapter 11, verses 27 to 30 are these words. In that time, some prophets went from Jerusalem to Antioch. One of them, named Agabus, stood up by the power of the Spirit, predicted that a severe famine was about to come over all the earth. It came when Claudius was emperor. The disciples decided that they each would send as much as they could to help their fellow believers who lived in Judea. They did this then and sent the money to the church elders for Barnabas and Saul. Second reading comes from the Gospel of Matthew, Matthew chapter 9, verses 35 to 38. The Gospel of Matthew, chapter 9, verses 35 to 38. Jesus has pity for the people. Jesus went around visiting all the towns and the villages. He taught in the synagogues, preached the good news about the kingdom, and healed people with every kind of disease and sickness. As he saw the crowds, his heart was filled with pity for them, because they were worried and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. So he said to his disciples, "The harvest is large, but there are few workers to gather it in. Pray to the owner of the harvest that he will send out workers together in his harvest." This is the word of God. May God help us in the reading of his holy words. May his name be praised now and forevermore. Just our notices for today. I welcome everyone and greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Talapalava, pakalapalayatu, kiorana, aloha, and greetings to you all. In Christ we trust. He is the way, the truth, and the life. On behalf of our team ministry, Reverend Kontiki Makani, who's going to be sharing our words this morning, Reverend Enera Wichman, and Reverend Mafala Koko, welcome to this morning's service. We look forward to the message our Father Minister will share with us this morning. A special notice for us, PIPC Newton, good news is that God is good. On Sunday, the 5th of July, 2020 at 11 a.m. we are going to worship together in our church at PIPC Newton, Edinburgh Street. We will start the day with a Holy Communion service. Thereafter, every Sunday in July at 11 a.m. we will worship together. That is all the Sundays in July, we will worship together at 11 a.m. All other church activities, including funerals and weddings, are suspended until further notice. On Sunday the 19th of July, we will review the situation whether we return to full service, and all details will be posted on PIPC Newton Facebook. So keep up with us and join us every Sunday, either online or at our church in Edinburgh Street. Keep well, stay safe, and God bless you all.
Our prayer of thanksgiving and intercession will be led by one of our elders, Sir Malu Kani.
Morning, church. Let us pray. God Almighty, God All-Powerful, God All-Knowing, and God who is everywhere, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, one true God, who is the Alpha and the Omega. We come before you as a church and declare and thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you, Lord God, for your everlasting love. Thank you, Lord God, that you are our Saviour, our Father, our Shepherd, our King, and our Friend. Thank you for giving us your only Son, Jesus Christ, who died on the cross, who carried the load, who took our sins. Thank you, Lord God, that 3 days later he rose from the dead. Thank you for that victory that you have over life and death. Thank you, God, for your word, which is a lamp unto our feet, a light to our path. Knowing your word, we will never be lost. Thank you, Lord God, for your Holy Spirit that comforts us, that leads us, that directs us and empowers us. May each day we be filled with your Holy Spirit. Thank you for your daily provision. You are so faithful, Lord, and you know our every need. Lord God, we ask that you will continue to bless us, your family. May we remain in your presence, even through the hard times. May you be with our Father Ministers, Reverend Makani, Reverend Witchman, Reverend Gokul. May you continue to bless them. May you anoint them with your heart and your wisdom. May they be men that will be kingdom focused. May they have a compassion for the loss and the suffering. Bless their wives and their children, Lord God. May we as a church and believers be blessed to know your will in our lives. May we walk daily in your ways. Bless our elders, bless our Sunday school teachers, bless our deacons and all our children within our church. Father God, we pray a blessing over our elderly parents, especially through these winter days. May they always be comforted by your love. May they know their value, and may we honour them for their hard work and their commitment in serving you. We believe that you are doing a new thing in our lives and in our church and in our community, even in the world. We receive your reading this morning for us, your children, to be workers called to gather in the harvest. Also that we may go into the world and make disciples and preach the good news of your Son Jesus Christ. In the name of the risen Lord, Amen.
message this morning is from both the texts that we have shared, reading from the book of Acts, chapter 11, verse 27 to 30, and Matthew 9, 35 to 38. The theme for our message this morning, discipleship, a servant's heart. Discipleship, a servant's heart. One of the central marks of discipleship is to serve in Christ's name. Friends, may grace and peace be yours in abundance in the knowledge of God and Christ Jesus our Lord. One of the main characteristics of discipleship is compassion. When we look at Jesus, his topmost attribute, his topmost quality was his compassion. Compassion is what encouraged him in all of his actions. The literal meaning of the word compassion means to suffer with. To suffer with. Compassion. When we feel compassion towards someone, we sense the pain and hardship they're experiencing. It's like we are putting ourselves in their shoes. Their trial becomes our trial. Their suffering becomes our suffering. The verses we heard from Matthew describe Jesus going about his ministries. He's traveling from town to town. And everywhere he goes, he teaches in the synagogues. And healing is a big part of his ministry. Matthew says that Jesus healed every disease and sicknesses. As Jesus looked out at the people gathered about him, Matthew says he was filled with compassion. Their pain, their loneliness, their grief, it all became his. He saw just how harassed and helpless they were. His response to the plight, trouble, was loving compassion. The theme for this morning, discipleship, a servant's heart. And that is what Jesus portrayed in his ministry. He served like a servant to everyone he met. No, a mighty warrior have a lion's heart. Or any soldiers, any five stars, they have a lion heart. But discipleship is different from any other traits in this world. In discipleship, you serve with a servant's heart, with compassion. And compassion forms the backbone of Jesus' mission. It was compassion that made him take on our human flesh in the first place. And compassion prompted him to pour himself out to death on the cross. As disciples of Christ, the church is required to be of the same mind as Christ, and from his mind to our hearts, and throughout every generation, compassion has been the calling of Christ's church. One of my favorite theologians, Moltmann, said, "The church exists for Christ's sake. The church exists for Christ's sake." As the church, Christ's compassion becomes our chief endeavor. Just as he was moved by compassion and acted from that compassion, we do must follow. We see this happening in the passage we heard from the book of Acts. The young church in Antioch perceives that a severe famine is about to strike. And when they hear about the forthcoming famine, their hearts are filled with compassion for their fellow Christians in Judea. Why Judea in particular? We don't know. Something must have made the community there more exposed to the future famine. The community in Antioch responds with a servant's heart. They determine to take up a collection to send relief. Each gives according to their ability. In each generation, the church has continued to respond to times of need with a servant's heart. And I believe that is what we do, particularly at this time, this point in time. We currently find ourselves right in the middle of such a time with the COVID-19 outbreak. And compassion calls to us. It calls to us to respond with a servant's heart. And we see examples of servant hearts all around us. And each person responds according to their ability. Medical workers who tirelessly treat patients, researchers working towards treatments and vaccines, truckers who ship vital goods from place to place, supermarket staffs, factory workers, all willing to work extra shifts in order to meet the demand for goods. Neighbors keeping track of one another. Volunteers reaching out to feed the hungry and help the weak. And everyone following practices to restrict the spread of the virus. A servant sees the needs of the neighbor. In doing so, the welfare of our neighbor becomes our chief concern. Just like Jesus said, we lose ourselves. We lose ourselves, but we gain our neighbor. And oddly, this loss brings us back to ourselves. In losing ourselves, we find ourselves, but not the same self we were before. No, this time we discover ourselves, transformed by the mind of Christ. The first generation church found they had a need for people to see the daily needs of their community. They needed people to oversee the hunger program, to feed the widows among them. And so they appointed deacons. And the church has been served by deacons ever since then. My friends, how has God called you to serve today at this time and point? As disciples of Christ, may we each be blessed with a servant's heart. May we continue to serve with a servant's heart. May we continue to preach the good news with the servant's heart. As Jesus has shown in his life, thus at his time, and to us today. Go ye therefore with a servant's heart. Discipleship with a servant's heart. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us stand and sing together our final hymn, one of the hymns that we sang together in church.
Amen.
crucifixion. Go in peace and love and care for one another. In the name of Christ Jesus, may the love of God our Father bless you and keep you. May the love of God the Son, our Lord, surround and fill you. And may the love of God the Spirit guide you and strengthen you on your journey, day by day, both now and forevermore. Amen. For me and my family, from us this morning, our clerk, Melanie Andrew, Elder Samalukali, and our technician, Tahira, and on behalf of the team ministry, may you have a blessed week.